Thanks so much for joining me today. We're talking about malignant brain tumors, and I'm hoping you can help me to understand when is surgery indicated for that diagnosis.
Well, thanks for having me. So surgery really is the primary treatment for nearly all individuals who have been diagnosed with the malignant brain tumor. The goal of surgery would be twofold. First, to obtain a diagnosis, understand exactly what type of malignant brain tumor we're dealing with, and secondly, to try to take out, in most cases, as much as we can as safely as possible. The surgical options range from everything from a needle biopsy, where we take only a very small piece of the tissue, purely obtain diagnosis, to much more intricate surgeries, such as awake craniotomy, where we keep the patient awake during tumor resection to maximize the extent of our tumor resection, as well as to ensure that the patient's neurological function is preserved during surgery.
Is surgery usually performed in conjunction with other treatment options?
Typically not. Usually, at the time of diagnosis, surgery is performed with the goal, again, of obtaining a diagnosis. But in rare cases, in a certain subset of brain tumors, we are able to place chemotherapy wafers, a technology that's been developed here at Johns Hopkins by our chairman, Henry Brehm, several years ago, in which we're able to deliver chemotherapy at the time of surgery, but this is only for a subset of patients.
What types of surgical options are there, and when are they used?
So the exact surgical option is going to be tailored to the needs of the individual patient. This really can span the gamut from a needle biopsy to awake craniotomy to intraoperative MRI, all approaches that are going to be based on where the tumor is located and what the patient's symptoms are, and to try to maximize safe surgery for that patient.
You mentioned intraoperative MRI. There are a number of technologies that are available here at Johns Hopkins that help you with surgery, aren't there?
Absolutely, and that's really been one of the biggest advances in the treatment of malignant brain tumors over the last 10 years, is our ability to understand the brain better before going into the surgical field. And that includes preoperative imaging, preoperative neuropsychological testing, intraoperative tools that allow us to define the boundaries of the tumor, as well as our ability to maximize extent of tumor removal. And this is really all in place to allow us to do safer and more effective surgery for our patients.
What would you say is the most important thing or things people should consider when they choose where to have treatment for a malignant brain tumor?
Well, this is a very important consideration. The number one consideration in my mind is the relationship between the patient and the providers that that individual is going to be interacting with. That includes the surgeon, anesthesia doctors, ICU team, as well as medical oncologists and radiation oncologists in many cases. And having a relationship that's comfortable and reassuring is very, very important. A second point to consider would be, what is the experience of the team that's taking care of you? Are there a vast number of patients treated at these centers? I think that's important because, thankfully, malignant brain tumors are in the realm of rare diseases, rare tumor types. So having a center that has vast experience is going to be very, very important.
You've told me, of course, that treatment is highly individualized, but I wonder if you can just offer some ideas about what surgery will be like, recovery time.
That's also a very important question. Typically, after surgery, which can last anywhere from 2 to 4 hours in most cases, patients are watched in the intensive care unit. And amazingly, most patients can actually leave the hospital 2 to 3 days after surgery, the vast majority of whom are able to regain normal neurological function and able to assume the next level of care as determined by the exact diagnosis.
And again, to emphasize the individual nature of this, I understand, but what about prognosis for different types?
That's certainly the most challenging question that we get on a daily basis. It all depends on the exact subtype of tumor that we're dealing with. There are certain malignant brain tumors that we've made incredible advances in, where we're able to cure a large fraction of those patients with that type of tumor. There are also other tumor types that unfortunately we haven't made such progress yet, but that doesn't mean there's no hope. It just means that we have to be very thoughtful and collaborative in the decisions that we make to help all these patients as best as we can.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you for having me.